Hello everyone, welcome back to Act of Learning. Our discussion in this video will primarily be about this integral. Many of us here would have encountered this integral in one form or the other in high school mathematics. Some may even remember that it evaluates to this seemingly complicated expression. Even if we didn't, if we think long enough, we may remember that this integral is taught as a classic example of solving integrals by trigonometric substitution. At this point, the plan to solve the integral would be simple. Use the substitution x is equal to a sine theta, evaluate the dx term, change the limits in terms of theta, solve the resulting integral, and done. What concerns me the most in this sort of an approach is that in our haste in solving the problem at hand, we usually fail to notice a beautiful geometric representation lurking behind. That representation, once unveiled, not only makes this integral completely elementary, but also tells us what the individual terms of the solution actually are. The process is so rewarding, we wouldn't need even a pencil paper the next time we solve this integral. Here's how we proceed. Of the many ways an integral can be interpreted, the one way that almost always springs to mind first is viewing an integral as the area under a curve y equal to f of x. The area under such a sufficiently smooth function can be approximated by a series of rectangles. As the number of rectangles tends to infinity and the width of the rectangle tends to zero, the total area of all the rectangles approaches the area of the curve. From that perspective, the integral we are interested in is in fact an expression for the area under the curve y equal to square root of a square minus x square between the lines x is equal to 0 and x is equal to b. But the curve y equal to square root of a square minus x square is one of the simplest and most familiar curves known to us. On the off chance you don't see it yet, simply squaring and rearranging the terms reveals that the curve we are looking for is a circle of radius a centered at the origin. And the integral is nothing but the area of the circle between the lines x is equal to 0 and x is equal to b. Finding this area is almost trivial. The section that we are interested in comprises a right-angled triangle and a circular sector. The sector has radius a and angle sine inverse of b by a. This gives the area of the sector to be a square by 2 times sine inverse of b by a. The triangle has base b and height square root of a square minus b square with an area of b by 2 times square root of a square minus b square. Adding these two areas solves the integral without using any calculus at all. I'm neither implying calculus is hard, nor am I against the use of calculus in understanding math. For example, one can come up with plenty of integrals where an alternate interpretation, let alone a geometric one, may not exist at all. But this integral clearly shows us that we must always look out for ways to solve a given problem with the simplest approach possible. Here, we solved an integral with nothing more than simple geometry. Before we conclude, can you evaluate this integral with a similar approach? See you in the next video.